Welcome back to another fire safety video with Firefighter Cafferata. We're here again at my house. We're talking about something important. We're talking about securing and fastening shelves, armoires, big cabinets to the wall. Now, every household has these gigantic cabinets. See this guy right here? This thing is massive. Weighs 400 pounds. I probably built it myself, so I hope it's secure. I also built this one over here. This one spans almost the whole wall. Now, we have to make sure these type of things are secure to the wall, especially in California. We have a lot of earthquakes, a lot of crazy things that happen all the time. Now, the way to do that is on the instructions, it comes like a little screw usually, and you fasten it to the cabinet, and then you have to go to the wall and do like a little string, blah, blah, blah. Don't do that. What you want to do is you want to go to like a Home Depot or supply store and you get like L brackets or some type of basically this guy right here, right? And you could get this basically at Home Depot and you could ask like where are your fasteners, right? And they'll point you out the right direction. What you want to get is you want to get one of these guys here, what I'm pointing at, and you want to get lag bolts or something that would be like, let's say, because you got sheetrock or plaster, I have plaster, and then beyond that, you know, there's about, I would say, half an inch that you need to go further beyond that to get to wood, right? So you want to get maybe like an inch long, if not longer, screw. And the dimensions of it, the size of it, if you just look at this head right here, you know, it's like a half inch head, if not a little bigger. It's probably maybe like a little bigger than half inch, but that's the head. The length would be like an inch to an inch and a half. And what you want to do is you want to get it to go into the stud so it can actually fasten to the wall. You also want to fasten it to the armoire or cabinet as well. And what you do is you find this by having like a stud finder. See this magical stud finder? And you kind of put it right to the wall and you find out there's a stud. And there happens to be a stud right here. So there's a stud here. And then you want to do it in two different places, okay? So this is one place. And then you could also do it, let me move this camera nice and smooth here if I can. And then here's another fastener right there. This helps fasten it to the wall and to the cabinet. You could also go even an extra length. You could actually go to the ground as well. If you go to the ground, it's a good idea because you're kind of like doing all encompassing, okay? Now I fasten both, this guy and then the guy across the room. Let me show you the one across the room. That one here, same type of thing. I fasten this guy to the floor as well, but you could see those brackets, you want to get those brackets from like a Home Depot. You could get washers that goes, you know, obviously washers, the screws or the lag bolts go through the washers to the wall. An inch and a half would probably be doable. And you want to get it through to the stud by finding a stud finder. You could also find those at Home Depot as well. There's electronic ones that are battery operated or there's like magnetic. They're both pretty good. I think electronic ones are really nice. The magnetic ones find nails, so maybe the electronic ones might be better. So then you fasten it to the cabinet, and that's it. So that's just this quick episode of fastening cabinets, being safe, and so you don't have any crushing injuries if there's an earthquake or some crazy disaster. This cabinet and all your cabinets can be fastened. I fastened this one also to the ground as well. You could get like a big L bracket that's flat, and you could drill long screws through the base, and that could be like 6 inches, depending on how high the base is off the floor. And you go through the floor, through the wood, and that'll help fasten to the floor as well. I would do that in kids' rooms. I would do that in your room, and talk to you soon. Thanks again for joining me. Join me next time on Fire Safety Tips. Thanks. Take care.